Today, I want to tell you about 7 things that I think are crucial for us to grow as developers. Let's go. Number 1. Don't fear deleting code. When you've spent hours or even days trying to solve a problem, the last thing you want to do is delete the code that you've written and admit that the path you are on doesn't work. I know, I've been there. We fear that all this work has been for nothing and that it will take just as long to write all this code again. Now, I'm here to tell you that 1, it was not all for nothing, and 2, it won't take as long to write it the second time. In fact, writing the wrong code is an essential part of thinking about the problem and thinking about the solution. It helps move us forward. We never get it right the first time, and even if we get it right the first time, we will still have to change it later anyway. In this ever-changing world, you have to move to stand still. To stay in business, we have to move forward. We have to evolve. We have to adapt or we will die. So we should always treat code as something transient, as something temporary that will have to change. So we should get comfortable with the idea of deleting code. And of course, if you don't already know how to version your code using a version control system like Git, then of course you should learn that. Nevertheless, check out my other videos if you're interested in the theory behind why planning doesn't work for many of the types of problems that we're trying to solve with software. You can also think of this as an instance of the sunk cost fallacy. As humans, we are reluctant to abandon things that we've invested heavily in, even if abandoning them would be the rational choice. If you want to dig down into that theory, I highly recommend the book Thinking Fast and Slow by Nobel Prize winning author Daniel Kahneman. Okay, tip 2. Define the goal. What do I mean? Too often, I see students banging their poor heads against the keyboard, desperate because they think that they've tried everything under the sun. And then they tell me something vague, like, it doesn't work. To which I, of course, reply, what doesn't work? And what do you mean when you say work? What is it that we are trying to achieve? In order to get something to work, those are some critical questions. Hammering the keyboard like a wild monkey is not a sensible way to write code. We have to know where we are going. So here's the model I would suggest. 1. Formulate the desired outcome. Define the goal. 2. Formulate a possible solution, a hypothesis of how you can solve this. 3. Try implementing that solution. And 4. If the solution doesn't achieve the desired outcome, then start over the loop again. Iterate. Tip number 3. Embrace debugging as learning. Having to debug your code doesn't make you a failure. We all make mistakes all the time. We should view debugging as an opportunity for deep learning about languages, frameworks, libraries, tools, techniques, patterns, principles, and so forth. So let me tell you how I debug. 1. I choose a place in the code where I think that the error might be. 2. I formulate a hypothesis in my head about what I think that the code actually does. 3. I debug to verify that the code actually does what I think that it does. 4. If the code didn't do what I thought it did, then I go deeper into the code to find the root cause and run the whole process again. If, however, the code did do what I thought it did, then I go outwards, upwards in the call stack, to whoever caused the program to end up in this point where I thought we had an error, and then I run the process again. So if we don't treat debugging as a blindfolded monkey that's throwing darts everywhere, then it can be an extraordinarily valuable opportunity to learn new things. Number 4. Find and follow mentors. As programmers, we are lucky because there are so many smart developers that have taken the time to share their deep thoughts with the world. Don't let this opportunity go to waste. Treat these people as mentors. Find them online, follow them online, and consume all their content. Watch their talks and read their books. There's a handful of people that have truly changed the way I think about software, that have affected my beliefs at the core. four. Let me mention a few names. Robert C. Martin, Martin Fowler, Kent Beck, Sandy Metz, Rich Hickey, Gary Bernhardt, Martin Kleppmann, Mishko Hevery, etc., etc., etc. So many fantastic people with such deep knowledge. Don't sleep on this opportunity. Check out the links in the description if you want to find some of the content that have blown my mind over the years. I believe in lifelong learning, so I'm always on the lookout for new mentors. So if you have tips, please let me know. Tip number five, articulate your ideas. On one hand, we are consumers of information, but on the other, I encourage you to become a producer of information. I love this saying by Peter Drucker, "No one learns as much about a subject as the one who is forced to teach it." No one learns as much as the teacher. In my experience, this is enormously true. I never learn as much as when I'm trying to explain something that I think that I know to someone else. Like you. So what am I suggesting? Talk to your friends, talk to your classmates, talk to your colleagues, do pair programming, do mob programming, write a blog, start a YouTube channel, do a devlog, use words, express yourself, explain yourself, have an opinion. Don't be afraid to articulate your ideas because it's the best way to learn. Tip number six, learn fundamentals, not frameworks. There are so many things in programming that are versions of things that we've seen before, but that now have been dressed in better marketing. Be wary of the shiny object syndrome. Don't follow the herd. When you find something new, try to figure out what the core idea is, the fundamental idea. Because if you can learn what is at the core, then your skills won't be useless when the next new shiny thing comes along. Also, this is why it's important to find mentors that operate at a higher level of abstraction and not just follow simple tutorials on the newest, hottest web framework. Go deep. Finally, tip number seven, explore other paradigms. We all start by learning one programming language. For many of us, that is an object-oriented language. But there are many great and highly relevant ideas in other paradigms as well. So be sure to at least explore both the object-oriented paradigm and the functional paradigm. And find mentors in both. Okay, those were my seven tips to maximize growth. Let me know what you think in the comments. Subscribe.